Hello and welcome to TPK Roleplay. Tonight we are continuing our Beyond the Undergrowth campaign with Session 8, Visions and Secrets, where our party had come across an elderly woman in Mbala, Granny Pu’pu, and then made their way to the ziggurat known as Orolunga. They faced three challenges and rose to the top of the steps to see a mysterious snake-like entity, a human, and a bipedal saurian creature. I am Tony, your Dungeon Master, and if everyone wants to go around, introduce yourselves in the overlay order.
Hello, everybody. We have a new overlay. Unfortunately, we have lost a party member for the time being. My name is Kohlrabi. I play Teleftheos, and I'm going to do that thing where I apologize now for my voice and mouth being weird and... You know, times are weird right now. Everybody's feeling some feelings, so we're gonna try to escape to a jungle, but that's about it for me.
Hello, I am Nerdwardo. I'm Johan Weiss, human sorcerer, and I feel like I'm really feeling the irony of us feeling the danger of the forest and wanting to go back in so soon. And that's just how he's feeling right now.
All right. Hello. My name is Harley, also known as Dungeonistics. Tonight I will be playing Nefrissa, the tiefling barbarian. And I'm going to just open with what I closed with at the last game. I should have been specific.
Hi,
it's life. Oh, I'm sorry.
No worries, you're fine. I'm proper nerdy Orindor Nick. I'm playing Herman Solace, the high elf paladin. And I think every day is just getting worse for Herman.
He is slowly descending into madness.
Pretty much.
Welcome to the Tomb of Annihilation campaign. That's all it is. So, yes.
Oh yeah, he was perfectly designed to just go through hell, literally.
But yes, the last time we came to this wonderful, glorious, it's not pulling up because it's being a butt, ziggurat. And we're going to pull you over back to Orolunga. When you guys reached the top of the steps, you heard the voice speak out to the other sitting within the dwelling that it will come back. It will not come back as long as Raz and Sti lives. You all stepped up and the entity looked at you. Welcome to my abode.
Well, this is a snake, and we've had a puzzle, so I know what we need to do with snakes, so I walk over and I swallow it.
What?
Well, you do notice that this large snake-like creature does have a human-esque visage, and it is also about much larger than you.
I mean, he doesn't discriminate.
That was very obviously out of game, seeing as it was in my normal person.
I don't know,
voice.
You didn't say that.
Yeah, you did just kind of say without specifying.
Cause,
I
cause
think it's...
my character voice is totally the same as my normal.
Roll
voice.
For Vore.
Roll for voice.
What brings those here after the trials?
We're just looking for something.
For
something,
you say.
Something got lost out here, and we're just trying to bring it back.
You all seem to notice that the insides of this area are, there are pillows and blankets and settings just all over the place here. In the center, there is a small brazier sitting on the floor that seems to be giving off a little bit of fire and a little bit of smoke.
Excuse me. Did you say there's a small brazier? Is that
brazier,
the real word?
Brazier? I don't know. Get out of here.
That's Britain.
A metallic bowl that has fire. How about
there
that?
There we go.
Anyway.
Brazier. That's the word.
Frasier, it's fine. Anyway.
Words aren't real. We made them up.
It seems to be giving off like a lighter smoke that seems to fill the area with a scent of like different floral just incense. And you also seem to notice a peculiar smell of ham. Unsure of where it's coming from, but very specifically ham.
I'm gonna look at the pillows. I'm not gonna move up to them or anything, but I'm just gonna like scan over them, and I want to see if there's any activity like under them. Maybe there's like snakes hiding under them. I don't know.
There's like some like a couple of bugs here and there, but you notice that there are also birds flitting from plant to plant on the outskirts, and they'll like come in, swoop and grab a bug and go back to their little potted plant or hanging plant and eat it.
Okay. No movement from the pillows, though?
No.
Okay. Can we do a perception or investigation roll, see if we can find where the scent of the source of the ham is, or is that just
you can do
story
a perception
plot?
Check based perception. Off of scent.
All right. You know what? We're going D&D Beyond Dice.
Oh, yes. I'm going to make a scent roll.
Sorry.
Yes! That's going to be a 17.
A 17. You notice, you believe it's coming somewhere near the incense, but because of how powerful the aroma is coming from it, you can't quite determine its exact location.
Understandable.
But the other two individuals in this room are kind of just giving you guys like an odd look, but not one of like hatred or malfeasance.
Herman is making a very similar look at all of them.
Is he way over there? He's doing that.
You and your map or whatever. Yeah, he's over here somewhere.
Hey, I made this map. Thank you.
It is a very good map.
I like it.
The snake kind of starts. The entity comes up. I am Saja Mbaza. Welcome to my abode. Please have a seat.
I'll walk
anywhere
in.
You would like would be fine.
I think I'll rather stand.
That is also okay.
We're popping a squat right there. Boom.
I assume you have come for guidance, as those have before you.
I honestly don't even know why the fuck we're here.
At least he's honest.
Hey, GM.
Yes.
Because this is listed as a sense and not as like a spell, I imagine the divine sense would be not like something that I could that like could I do without having without giving that up?
Oh yeah. It's just a straight up. You have a sense.
Secretly, that's the word I'm looking for.
Yeah, can do that. Subtly.
So subtly, as I lower myself onto one of these pillowy things. I'm going to attempt to double check there aren't any baddies or I guess some goodies around. So that is
that detects
being affected by the hallow spell or no location of any celestial fiend or undead within 60 feet. I
you
can detect good and evil.
Alright. You do not detect any of the creature types. And you do sense an aura of goodness coming from the snake-like entity.
What are the two behind him?
The one you get no reading whatsoever from, the human.
Mm-hmm.
The other one you get a sense of good.
Good to know.
You asked if we were here for guidance. We actually just stumbled upon this place and found it interesting and wanted to explore.
She's gonna probably vibe check you.
Nice.
I mean, I haven't been dishonest. I don't know why the fuck we're here. But also, you guys lost your scribe and your person who pays like super attention, so Someone else gotta take up that.
That's Johan now.
Yeah, I know. I'm doing it. I'm doing it. Vibe check me. So,
were you being honest with her?
I'm great being question. Half truthful because we did kind of explore it because we thought that the automaton might be here, but we weren't like searching this place out.
I only asked because you were also tasked by Granny Pu’pu about grabbing one of its scales, and I wasn't sure if that's on your top scales. Tier of things to do.
I definitely remember we were doing.
Yeah,
yes,
totally.
That we were definitely doing, and we're mm-hmm.
that was the thing that was totally on the schedule.
Jim, yes. for this thing that I definitely remember from last session, what exactly did she ask for?
She would like one of the iridescent scales from the Guardian of Orolunga.
Orolunga, that is a word.
I did not expect this to be the Guardian, if I'm being honest.
I don't think it is, but that's okay.
You can always ask.
Scale. That's my note. Pu’pu wants scale.
Man, if only you guys did not kill Will.
Listen, I didn't kill Will.
So, yeah, Johan isn't doesn't have that on his mind at all.
Okay.
When saying this.
So up to you if you want to give any sort of roll against it, but she got a 21, so...
Yeah, I wasn't, like, intentionally trying to deceive, so...
Okay. Well, if you have any questions, I could enlighten you. I am, of course, here for eternity.
That's a long time.
Eternity, you say?
Eternity.
Yes, I protect the ziggurat Orolunga.
What is
you
there
You must
to
pass
protect?
The trials to actually affect it.
Just looks like a bunch of pillows.
Well, looks can be quite deceiving as she, like, eyes you up and down in your garb.
That's very
Is one
fair.
Of these pillows special?
Hmm?
Do we have to, like, pick the right pillow?
Yeah.
And no, there are no special pillows here. Damn. They are just an assortment that I have gathered over my times here.
Who are your friends?
I guess lost to time. As all beings are. But it
you
is not a sad loss.
Where or who?
I said, who are your friends?
They could be... Some I would not call friends. They are beings I know of.
All right, slit their lips, cut the shit. Who are these two people standing right here in front of us that aren't you?
Why do you not ask them yourself?
Hey, who are you? You two over there, specifically pointing you, man, and you thing I've never seen before.
The one, again, is a human. He gives you kind of a look and just like, wow, this guy's kind of not polite, but okay. He says, my name is Arthur. And this is my companion, Dragonbait.
Dragonbait.
Mm-hmm.
Dragonbait.
That's a cool
and
name.
Nethrissa, since you've done it before, you now are getting a scent of brimstone.
Brimstone?
Yes, which is very odd because that shit ain't here.
Remind me what brimstone is, good.
It smells like brimstone.
Burning like hell-ish things. And
okay.
Fire-ish stuff.
Okay, okay.
Yes, the brimstone smells like brimstone.
yes, the floor is made out of floor.
These snowsberries
taste
like snowsberries.
No. This is Mr. Arthur.
It smells foul.
Pay no mind.
December.
Pay no mind to the name that it gives. That is Arthur. Dragon bait.
Alright. Cool. Why would you
so
ever want to be bait for a dragon?
Well, it's more of a nickname from another time.
You fight a dragon?
Well,
bait for a
yes
dragon?
And no.
Could you bait a... Never mind.
TOS, mister. Get out of here.
All right. Like I said, times are weird. You cannot blame us for any hijinks or memes that are had tonight.
Cole is losing mental stability as we speak.
But to be...
What is this called, Cthulhu?
To move it along, Tell's satisfied with his questions, so he's just going to sit back and let you guys ask questions unless someone threatens you. And then
finally, host.
Yes, how can I help you?
What is the importance of this temple?
This ziggurat stood as a temple almost to Ubteo for millennia. But
I'm sorry, I'm unfamiliar. What was that you said?
A temple to Ubteo.
I don't recognize that god.
He is less of a god in your lore books, I assume. He was a primordial, one of the few of this world.
Dear DM, who knows far more about lore than any of us would ever imagine. What is a primordial?
For those at home, primordials are essentially what were created as, like, the elemental superpower beings other than the gods.
So were they before, after, or during gods?
They were more or less during gods, and they all fought. Essentially, big booms happened. We're now in Toril. Primordials are on Abair, but Ubteo is one of the few that's allowed to stay on Toril because he's a cool dude with other things that I'm not going to go into because spoilers.
Nice.
But Ubteo is the prime protector, or was the prime protector of Chult.
Excellent.
I keep this temple safe to keep his connection here.
Is there anything here people would want to steal? Is this what these tests were for?
There
what
are
is it that you are
things.
Truly gardening. Oh, gardening, Jesus gardening. Christ.
Gardening.
Well, you see these potted plants. I garden quite
shush.
Often.
Shush, y'all. Shush. I'm
this
trying to be serious
barrier.
And in character. What is it that you are guarding in this on this temple?
Things that better left unsaid. Those that could delve into your mind might learn how to obtain these things and destroy Orolunga, and I would be powerless to stop them.
But aren't you the guardian of this temple here? You couldn't prevent
my
it from
powers
happening?
Do have a finite limit.
So I know that this primordial is primarily in the good realm.
Yeah.
Okay.
So are we getting that this is the guardian of Orolunga, the snake?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Hey, how much for one of your scales?
One of my scales?
Yeah.
Someone
who needs one.
Oh, she's going to vibe check you.
I mean, it's the truth.
Oh, I know, but she's gonna
say,
like, why? You have some kind of, we'll see if she's gonna find out if you got a...
Does she get disadvantaged because she can't even see my face?
No, it'd be in the words.
Johan is like mentally like breaking down at this point because he's terrified of fighting this thing.
Okay, so you know,
she can't see my face and does not know my real voice, so, you know, she can vibe check me all she wants.
She's got a 19.
Let's do a baby.
So you want me to roll what? I'm not deceiving.
No, she's more or less understanding that there might be more than just wanting her scale.
Nope. I just want her scale.
Who asked you for one of my scales?
Some lady back there that makes terrible soup.
I thought it was good.
It was pretty good soup.
An elderly lady.
That's what I said.
Yeah.
I do believe she went by the name of Pu’pu.
She happens to live atop this plateau nearby.
The last surviving member of Mbala, as far as I'm aware.
Oh, she's been trying for years.
And what exactly would a iridescent scale of yours do?
Oh, she could do quite a lot, since she's more than she appears to be.
I mean, she can make a mean soup, but, like, what are we talking here?
You only must have seen her facade.
I mean, I saw children's bones in her.
We saw this, and then I pull out the drawing of the holy symbol.
Ah, yes.
So here's the better question. What will you do to have us on your side instead of hers?
I do not take sides.
You wouldn't be taking it, we would.
Understand that she is a vile creature of the Feywilds.
I can definitely see that.
Fey?
I mean, she did make River sick for like 2 full days.
Yeah.
She tracks those with her right of life and has been trying to grab one of my scales for several years, sending adventurers to me.
Well, obviously she has ulterior motives. We knew that all along. Do you have anything to offer us if we'd get rid of her so she doesn't send people here all the time?
Sending heroes here is not an issue. I can enlighten them like I have just done for you.
That is if we trust you.
Those that would find too strong of an ill will find it too difficult to finish the tasks.
She mentioned something.
GM?
Mm-hmm.
Sorry. Simber or Kimber?
It's Simber, but you don't know that yet.
Oh, do they introduce themselves at all or
not? Yep, it's Arthur and Dragonbait.
Arthur. I know something that my character doesn't, and I don't like.
Yep.
Gosh darn it! Why couldn't you just crop your?
I didn't think about it till it was far too late.
Gosh darn it!
That's his mythical name in the handout.
All right, how about I vibe check this snake lady and see if I kind of want to figure out what kind of alignment she's leaning towards, if any way possible.
Go ahead.
All right. I mean, I already know.
Herman knows, but he hasn't spoken up.
Okay. Well, also, what do you want me to roll?
Keep your secrets, Herman.
You can give me an insight check.
I'm not just going to be like, hey, y'all, we're good. She's good.
Yeah, I just somehow checked her out. Everything's fine.
Well, I cannot see.
I used my magic voodoo powers.
I cannot see very well through the skull that is adorned to my face, and I rolled an 8.
As far as you can tell, you're pretty sure this, whatever she is, has done nothing but speak the truth to you.
So, going back, Tell never trusted the old lady anyways, so he's already like, yeah, fuck that old lady.
That's pretty much where
I think that's where everybody is right now.
Yeah.
I was going to say to her, she did mention something about a right of life, I believe.
Yeah, that thing.
Ah, yes, that's what she calls it.
Yeah, she's kind of vague about it.
Of course, she is of the Feywild. She would never tell you her exact issues with it.
I just feel betrayed. That was some good soup.
Yes, the soup was very good, but...
Oh, speaking of, and she kind of like reaches underneath one of the pillows and pulls out like a little chest... If you require nourishment, please have some.
I never take food from strangers.
Is it open?
Inside is just like little sachets of rations.
Unlike the tall one, I do take food from strangers, and I just get a equivalent of a plateful in ration terms.
How tall sure. am I? I need to see if I set that. Did I set it? Don't mind me. I'm just.
You notice that the rations themselves are like, there's some jerky to it. There's nuts, some dried fruits. It looks pretty good.
Are there lemons?
No, that would spoil.
Oh, he's gonna add a hint of lemon to everything he eats.
Again, it has soy. It would spoil. How do you have a fresh lemon?
No,
yeah, he's got prestidigitation.
Oh, he's just making it flavor.
Yeah.
Does the sailor know that flavor of lemon does not have vitamin C?
He doesn't know that. He's not that smart.
It's fine. He'll just get scurvy and figure it out.
I am 7'8", exactly. By the way, for future reference.
Oh, Lord.
7'8".
I think
wow.
Metro's is 6'5".
All right. Cutting to the chase, because Tell does not have patience. What are we looking for that doesn't involve this old lady, and can anyone ask her for help with that? The automaton, but Tell doesn't know as much about that as you guys, so do you guys want to ask questions about other shit than this old lady? She's old.
No,
news.
No, Tell.
I mean, I got...
Herman's going to kind of hush Tell from saying things like old lady and ship.
language.
Not that he really cares about language, but he understands that this guardian is, you know, upper crust or whatever you want to say, but also old as fuck. He's first going to look across to our good friend Arthur and say, Arthur, tell me. What brought you out to this temple here?
I had a few questions I thought the guardian Saja could answer for me.
And has she?
She has, albeit not the exact answers I was hoping for.
That sounds accurate. Now, we are adventuring because of, as you are probably well aware, the death curse that we has spread across our lands.
A death curse.
Are you aware? I forget what it's called. Is it called death curse? I don't know.
No, it's called death curse.
Okay, good. Okay, I'm just making sure that I didn't
say it
wrong.
I've heard of it. I think Dragonbait and I have been in the jungle for a while, but only rumors that.
How long have you two been in the jungle?
They kind of look at each other like, honestly?
Let me check my personal planner.
Hey, you two. Are you even with the living?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
They look at each other, and then, like, the smell of brimstone becomes stronger. Yeah.
Are they alive?
Can we insight check? Can we
as far
check?
As Herman is aware, they are alive. They're not undead.
Okay.
Well, the saurian is alive. He got no pings from the human.
Yeah, can we, can I vibe check them?
Sure.
Okay. What is my insight? +4, I think? Oh, +5, that's better.
And you do notice the saurian does not speak at all.
That's a 10 on my vibe check.
Didn't he specifically say, oh yeah, my name is like an old joke. No, that was the human, I guess.
As far as you can tell, Johan, he is speaking the truth.
Okay.
As far as you can
Which is
tell,
never a good thing to hear from far, a GM, because
that
means...
That's the best way tell. To say, as far as you can tell,
he
continue it.
He thinks he's telling the truth.
All right.
He has no reason to believe
objectively the truth.
Just this another handful.
This is important to me, so I'll turn to the snake. Since they don't know, are they with the living?
Saja looks over at them. Yeah.
Thank
the
you.
The undead are not able to enter my sanctum.
Oh.
Good to know.
Notes.
Hey, I have a question for you. I'm gonna look at the snake lady. we ate those snakes a while back. Are those like still in us, or like what's the deal with that? Because like
oh, they are a test. They will not affect you. Do not worry.
Okay. I mean, like, I don't mind eating snake, but like that was a little jarring in the moment, so like, but like I'm here now, so
it's what very much helps define the living from the dead.
So,
it's all making sense. No, it's not.
So if somebody were to die and come back to life from a, I guess you would say holy point rather than necromancy, would they be able to enter?
Such as your people's terms of resurrection.
Yes,
that is still fine.
You guys,
but undeath is an issue.
Why are we asking stupid questions? Do you know any?
Yes, let's get to the point.
We are in search
of something.
Yes, and thank you, Armin.
You seem to be quite knowledgeable on Chult and the history. You've probably been here for quite a long time. Would you happen to know of anywhere in Chult, either you or our fellow adventurer friends, of a automaton of a sort? Seems to be controlled by an amulet of some kind.
I am not sure what you mean by an automaton.
Oh, you know, a constructed being that can be controlled through the use of some kind of magical or otherwise implement.
And Saja is going to take the tip of her tail underneath another pillow and pull out a little bit of incense and kind of throw it into the fire and kind of look into the smoke. And you'll see her eyes kind of change color for a minute. And she's, the goblins of Yelyark. They could probably assist you. Apparently, they find it a divine being.
I'm going to look over to Arthur and... Sorry, I love saying Arthur. It's not a fancy fantasy name like Artus, but no, it's Arthur. I mean, I can't say anything. My name is Herman. So, anyway, I'm just making fun of you because you said the wrong name. I'm going to look over to the two of them and see if they respond at all to that name.
Yelyark?
Either of them.
No, I meant like they're responding to Yelyark.
The goblins of whatever.
They don't really seem to.
Do they seem to recognize the name or not at all?
Are you going to ask?
Well, I would ask, but I'll ask in character. I'm asking out of character. Do they make any kind of response? Or just like, oh, yes, I've heard of them. Or is it like a, oh, God, the goblins, how could you?
As far as you would have noticed, they didn't really seem to like change their body language at all when they heard Yelyark.
Okay. You ready for this, GM? Okay. I'm unfamiliar with these particular goblins. Could you tell me more, either of you?
They look at each other for a minute, like they live quite a while north of here, but they're one of the few established goblin colonies on Chult.
And is that from who or who? Who's that from?
That's only from Arthur.
And you are guardian friends here?
They are an odd people. They seem
though
to...
I assume you have very little connection with them.
They do not come and seek my guidance, but
well, I appreciate they are them less. They are what?
They're an odd colony.
So here's another question then. Are they particularly hostile, or is it just other people that assume the worst of them? My people have been the butt of many of the same responses from different people.
These are how do I put it? They are not uncivilized, but the dangers of the jungles of Chult make them skittish and uncertain.
How would we win their favor instead of inciting an outright fight?
I am unsure. I do not know.
Okay. Well, otherwise, I have one more question, and then I will shut up. Is there anything that you need that you would ask of adventurers?
That's quite selfless of you, Tom.
Well, I would like to help you more with this death curse you speak of. It sounds quite unnatural.
Are you familiar with it? Obviously,
as much as I would like to.
So you say you have a problem with the undead, but no such problem with the revived.
Yes.
If we were to come back at a later date, would you be able to tell us more? Would you be able to collect any information? Or
sadly,
is it simply the whims of whoever happens to arrive here?
Sadly, this is a one-time ordeal.
Arthur, did you summon this being?
He shakes his head no.
Then where shall you go after we are gone?
Oh, it is not where I go. It is where the powers bestowed upon Orolunga go. You may only enter this sanctum once.
In that case, I have one question. I got bit by a were-tiger maybe a week ago. And I'm kind of terrified. Is there something I could do about that?
She uses, you know, like the tip of her tail to like beckon you closer to her.
I'm going to approach carefully.
Well,
I should probably do
show
that
me where it bit you.
Where did it bite
me,
on the champ?
Dog.
Just probably on the arm. It's not going to be like a weird place.
I just like
on the back of your left ankle.
I take like a full 2 minutes trying to like roll up my sleeve like around the straps of the pauldron.
Okay, so you see, she is typically like an off yellow kind of sclera. You see her speak a few words, and her sclera just turns bright blue. And she looks at it and kind of coils almost like around you, but not touching you, and looks, you do not seem to be afflicted with lycanthropy.
Oh, thank God.
It seems your body was able to stave it off.
I'm happy. Thank you.
Just how far do your powers of knowledge go?
Well, where is more when, but there are, again, a few entities I remember or can feel the presence of through the connection of the land.
If we want to talk to you again, how would we do it?
You would need strong divination magics. Essentially, you need like commune or contact other plane.
Well, we're a couple levels away from that, but we'll get there.
Oh, meta.
I do not know what you mean by levels, but that is understandable.
Pay no attention to that. His vocabulary is a bit weak at the moment.
And she kind of looks over at Arthur and his friend. If you two would kindly step out for a moment. And, you know, they do. I would like to have you all gather around my... I'm not remembering the name for it, but the fire pot.
The brazier.
The not brazier.
The teacup.
Yeah, yes, the D cup of fire.
The D cup of fire.
We need another magic item, please.
She motions you around it to gain a reading from her.
I punch you.
I understand that this death curse has been afflicting the land. It has become more unnatural and soils it. I can feel it, but not quite where. And you hear, like, the birds kind of, like, stop flitting around. Any of the bugs on the ground hide. And she grabs out a new bowl of incense. And she throws it on the fire. And it just explodes into a myriad of colors,
my God,
darkened smoke.
Wow.
Double rainbow.
So bright.
What does it
mean? And her eyes go from being yellow to white to black. And finally to green. And she speaks, but it's not her normal voice.
Oh?
Is it
my voice? Bert,
from Bert and Ernie.
Whoa!
Hubris shields desertion. Spirits shield blood.
Green. Whoa.
Steps of
thunder. Feathered flu. Copy that name.
A riddle of squares.
You guys shut up, I'm listening. A serpent stew.
Blue summons blue. Stop talking during the movie.
Suffering. A bargain in tours. Many forked paths. An unlikely ally whence doubt blooms. A lost child beckons. All heed its call. The pale consumes. Another devourer.
Cool. I'm just gonna be writing this entire thing down in Will's notebook as it as it's read aloud.
Old bones creak, eyes upon you, a twin to a sin. Blackened fingers lies in ruins. Winter's groom. Orb of darkest night. Two powers chained. Woven by three. Feast for the gods. Skulls of five. A sixth lair. Seven hands obey. Eight can reverse. Vengeance salts ninefold. Coiled schemes.
And you see her eyes drop the colors and go back to normal.
Shit, that was
that
impressive.
Was terrifying.
But it was so long.
That sounds like a prophecy.
Yeah, sounds like it. Cool. The barbarian isn't that smart, so she doesn't really know what to say about that.
Cool story, bro.
Cool story.
TLDR.
These are quite troubling visions.
There was a lot of numbers in there.
Would you have any clarification by any chance that you might know of?
Unfortunately, I do not. These visions can be helpful, but vague. You do have that as a handout, though. It's.
Well, I already copy and pasted into my notes just in case. This divination sounds annoying. I'm speechless.
But there seems to be ways to find the place that which you seek through the knowledge and powers of the ancient beings of Chult other than myself.
More like there are more places similar to this one?
Not precisely. More like ancient beings, like not necessarily like myself, but two of them are still here. I can sense them, but their names escape me.
How close are we talking?
One is actually quite close. The other seems to be on the other side of Chultz from here. However, they have a common interest.
The other one is in the other direction. Is that kind of like where we came from, or is it the opposite way? Or
it's on like the east coast of Chultz.
And which way did we come by?
We came from north to the west.
Yeah.
Okay.
Their common interests being bones of a green dragon that have yet to be buried. They lie on the eastern edge of Chultz, north of the monastery known as Kur Sabal.
Kur as in C-U-R-R?
K-I-R.
K-I-R, thank you.
Think anything is spelled the way it's supposed to be?
Welcome to D&D.
Not in this fantasy universe.
Not in my tabletop.
Your closest being lives beneath the plateau of Mbala. It feeds off the natural life force of the jungle granted by Ubteo. The other lives within its lush gardens in an ancient city known only as Nangalore.
Oh, yeah?
So, guardian under the plateau. And in Nangalore.
But there is a third option, one that may not grant you your direct knowledge of the Death Curse's location, but may bestow great power to you.
Who would that be? Where would they be?
Lay the bones of the dragon to rest in the in-sea wastes just south of the monastery. The lands were once beautiful, then they now lie in ruins. The bones will make the area lush with life once more, and would make the protector of the lands happy once more.
What monastery are you talking about?
Kur Sabal.
Sabal.
Whichever you decide, I may be able to assist you with what connection I still have to this land.
What do you mean, what we decide?
Well, if you even decide to do this at all, really.
It's the best lead we've gotten in quite a long time, so honestly, we will probably visit all of the above.
So I think, as far as we know, we have no other leads after we get this automaton that we're looking for, so you know, this might come in handy later.
I may be able to give you something. It can help you cross great distances in short time, and it may be able to bring those close to you with you.
You know,
as a one-way trip.
Aaron's been really quiet right now. What do you have to say, Aaron?
Wow, really? You're gonna pull one of those?
Aaron dies.
Aaron
sitting there, you know, like arms on her knees. Just, I don't know. It seems really sketch, but.
I mean, I think Aaron's in a similar position as Tell, where they weren't with us before, they're only with us for circumstantial reasons.
Yeah, they all, like,
I mean, Herman probably would have at least informed them of everything that had happened so far.
That's true.
You've had plenty of days together.
It's not as like we were like, yeah, I'm not telling you anything. What are you talking about? Just come with us.
But also put your wife on the line.
I mean, also though, Aaron was also like looking for picks to capture him.
Mm-hmm.
So if like we should put that in, like have that in mind too, on how much we told Aaron.
I mean, we already told her that Pix is gone, so.
Yeah.
Yeah, we went to. And
she doesn't care.
So, without any mumbo jumbo out of game, is the Guardian offering to send us to a location for a certain thing and we have to pick which one?
She's offering you suggestions on gaining more information as to where this death curse is, aside from her visions, that might help you locate it. She's also offering you two boons, one to each of you, and then one to help you cross a great distance in a short amount of time.
What's in it for you?
What do you want to call it? Bringing this land back to what it once was. This death curse gone. Possibly the wastes return to normal. And NC's death.
Being not of this world, what do you care about it?
I am still somewhat tied to this land. If it is to be corrupted and destroyed, so will I.
I mean, that's a pretty good reason to tell.
Well, I trust whatever Herman decides, and we're in it for the long haul.
I say we start with the goblins of Yabba something something.
We were contracted to put that automaton back. Although I feel like it will be quite difficult to get them to let us take their god away from them.
While I am very intrigued by the monastery you talk about, I think it is in our best interest to start there.
With the goblins of Yo-York.
Do you know how to get there?
Could you guide us?
Physically, no, but they do live a ways north of here.
You spoke of some assistance in traveling a ways.
Yes, it, however, requires a willing participant.
I'm willing. I'll do it.
I would need your left hand.
I do not like hearing those words. Off?
Would you like my hand off?
Tony, I do not like hearing that sentence coming from you so soon.
That's a funny joke, DM.
What did I do?
You know what you did.
Do I, though?
I need a willing participant. I need a willing participant.
I have two-handed weapons.
And she just needs to see your left hand. It's all she's asking for.
First it's baiting a dragon.
Thanks for taking him onto the team, Johan. I'm going to smack him on the shoulder.
Your left hand.
I'm left-handed. I'm actually asking, does it need to come off?
What, your hand?
Yes. Does my hand?
No, she just needs your. Off. She just needs, like, if you have a glove on, take it off.
Like, I'm okay. So, me asking her directly, she says, no, it's not going to come off.
No, your hand will not be removed from your body. That is not my intention.
A rough few weeks. Don't mind him.
Inside check.
You can vibe check her.
You know what? I'm just gonna go with it.
That was a 14.
Glove comes off. As far as you can tell, my eyes.
She's telling the truth.
Okay.
Yeah, my glove just comes off, and I'm putting my hand. I'm like outreaching my hand towards her with my eyes closed. All right.
Her tail begins to wind around your hand up to your wrist, and it starts to squeeze, and it starts to squeeze really hard. And it actually becomes painful. And you take 10 damage.
Oh!
However, she then releases... you see something glow on your hand and she releases her grip. And only seen to you, you see the symbol of Upteo on your left hand.
Symbol of Upteo.
But I also see it.
How do you see it?
It's right in front of me.
Listen, Linda. No. It's for his eyes only.
I got That did max damage to me, of course it did.
Yeah,
it
did. she tells you, just focus in your mind's eye of where you wish to go, even if you know only a name. This will take those near you with you to where you'd like to go. The more clear your vision, the closer you will be.
Do we need to hold hands, or will it just happen?
It will just happen.
Is this just for Chol?
There's one way to find out.
Cool.
Nithris's
house.
She does. you do have to like legitimately focus.
Yeah,
it takes like a minute
to go. That was a joke.
I'm closing my eyes and like channeling the magic that I already know how to do and like trying to get it to focus in my hand. And
like you'll
just
see like the you see it, your magic to in your eye, you'll see your magic actually flow into it and start filling out the maze that is the symbol.
Yo, that's cool.
But nobody else sees it.
I'm just like staring at my hand very intensely as this is happening. Yo-York, everyone?
Some place to start.
Fire away,
before you leave, is there anything specific I could assist you with?
Yeah, why am I smelling brimstone around here?
Oh my god.
Actually, the scent of brimstone has wafted away at this point.
Okay, well, then I'll rephrase my question. I was smelling brimstone earlier. What was up with that?
You can't just ask people why they smell like brimstone.
I wasn't asking her why she smelled like brimstone.
I am not sure.
Oh.
It was not my incense.
I would like to fly.
You would like to
tell them what he wants.
If you really believe in fairies.
He reaches out her tail for your right hand.
He extends it. It's covered in bones and all sorts of stuff and gloves.
So, Cole, or Tel, as you ask her for the ability to fly, a symbol will appear on your right hand on the top and only visible to you.
You just get magic? That's cheating.
Well, I guess I can put this in everybody's, but it's really just for Cole.
Dope. That's why you don't ask stupid questions, guys.
But yeah, you just feel like this surge of power into your hand, and you now have this charm.
But also, I'm just playing a character, so no hard feelings. You're all great. You're all doing great, sweetie.
Is there anyone else?
My turn. Can you like, I don't know, my thing's being strong and stuff. Can you make me like stronger?
Be stronger.
Yeah.
He reaches, tail comes out. She asks for your hand.
I'm gonna, which one? I got
your right hand.
All right. Right hand out.
She grasps it.
Firmly grasp it.
Firmly grasp it.
And upon your right hand, there will be a symbol, as shown, the charm of strength.
Yeah! Cool.
That, again, only you can see.
All right.
Channel it to gain the powers that it says.
Cool.
And what of you, as he looks over to Johan, because it's just been going in order.
Wait, I get another one?
Well, on your other hand, if you wish, but this will not hurt.
Can I, like, be a better dodge or, like, be able to not get hit as much, please? I'm very sensitive.
He's squishy.
Emotionally and physically.
You should ask.
Toss him. I could toss him, like, easy.
She can, like, we have done it.
Can, like, lift him above my head.
I
motion for you to
pick
me up.
I do not believe I have the powers to grant you a stronger defense, but I believe something else could assist you. And she leaves out her tail.
Yeah, all right. I like to gamble, and I just put my hand out.
All right. And this time, this little bit of a starburst will come out for you.
Starbursts? I love starbursts.
Hey,
more healing.
A healing. A charm of healing.
It's like the other week's dream.
And then looking over to Herman. How can I assist you?
Even out of character, I have no fucking clue. I don't know.
Oh my god, guys, like, don't make me choose my boon. That's, like, so embarrassing.
how about...
I can't believe you guys are making me do this. Oh my god.
Like, out of character, Nick hates presents that he asks for. He likes presents that people
ask
have thought
for the
about
ability
for him.
To actually remember stuff so we know where we're going.
Right? I mean, that's something that Tony can help me out with, though.
I would like the feat Keen Mind.
There, let's put it this way. We'll get back into character now. There is much about Schultz that confuses me. I wish that I had a stronger grasp to perceive the complexities that Schultz offers.
And she reaches her tail out to you.
Do I take it? Do I stroke it?
You take it with your right hand.
For some reason, it's just like, and I pet her tail.
That's weird.
I'm
she
confused.
Feels uncomfortable.
No, sorry. I do whatever the other people did.
And on your right hand, you will see this symbol appear.
Well, that's cool.
I get to see this. Oh, that's awesome. I love that. Oh, that's super nice. DM,
so
is
the
there
strength
a way,
one, go on.
Is there a way for me to add these like to my D&D Beyond? Or is this like level 20 stuff?
I'll have to see if I can add something for D&D Beyond.
They only last a certain amount of time, so you should probably
yeah, the charms. The charms will essentially stay on you until you use them up to their charge number,
mm-hmm.
And then they're gone.
So the charm of strength, it just—it's so
it's
a one-time.
That charm of strength will, yeah, it'll sit on your hand, and when you use an action to use it, it goes away, and you gain the benefits of what it do.
Okay, so that I'll just add a. Potion of giant strength and use that as
yeah to. Essentially
okay sounds
mine's
good
kind of complicated
yeah yours is a little more
potion of giant strength.
It's also
I
in world
pretty
20
neat,
so
for you Cole yours is like yours last 10 days like after activation
yep
just 10 days of feather falling.
Whoa, I'm actually reading this. What?
Yeah, it gives you like a
25 strength?
Yep.
My god.
I'm gonna fucking kill Johan in one hit, bro. The son of flying off of this pyramid thing.
I'm gonna expend
it's only
all
once.
My charges at once.
I mean, once is all I need. If I'm at this height and I just toss him real good.
It lasts for an hour, I believe, or a minute.
Nobody yes, is killing hour. Anybody if I have
I
anything to say
for
about
an hour.
It. As he walks over and just puts a huge meaty hand on Mithras's head and pats it as he says that.
It's a joke, like it's a joke. I'm not being serious. Don't look at me like that.
It's not a joke. It's
shut
not
up.
A joke.
Shut up, Johan. Shut up.
Is there any other questions that I could assist you with?
Do you know my true form?
Yes.
Damn, that's weird.
You
have a costume?
Form. Is it more intimidating than this one?
Did you just ask if I have a costume?
Is this a costume? I don't know. I don't know you that well.
I'm
man.
Not wearing hockey pads.
What the fuck is hockey?
Yes. Okay, so now Cole has inadvertently made hockey a pastime of Schultz, which I'm not sure if I'm okay with that.
I mean, you weren't okay with the meat ladder, but it's still here.
It's still here.
Yeah, no, I'm still not okay with the meat ladder.
Nobody's okay with the meat ladder.
No,
it doesn't exist.
No, you know what? The fun people are okay with the meat ladder.
Anyway.
Fun, she says.
If you are
people, she says.
Of your friend there's true identity, I am not one to reveal other secrets if they wish to keep them like that.
I appreciate that about you.
But I will warn you, if you do plan with those bones of the green dragon, and you do not plan to just bury them, but give them away to the two entities, be mindful that these entities are not necessarily benevolent nor malevolent at face value.
So we have to be very careful, okay? Yes. I look at Tell.
One is more ancient than I. The other, not as much.
More ancient.
It has been in this land for an incredibly long amount of time.
Is it? Do you know if it's native to this plane or if it would?
It is not all. To this plane of existence?
To the material plane.
Yes. But it is not native to Chult.
Oh. This just keeps getting more and more interesting, doesn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Thank you for your assistance. It's been quite helpful.
Oh. Thank you, Sasha.
I thought
you were going to ask what her name was.
Yes, that is your name, but thank you for your assistance. It's been quite useful.
Yeah, thanks for all the information and the cool knickknacks in our hands.
You are most welcome.
12 charisma, baby.
18 charisma, baby.
17 strength, baby.
Are there any further questions?
Done with your shit, baby. I think you've been more than helpful.
Yeah.
Thank you kindly. We best be on our way. We have people at home who are in need of speedy recovery.
I am sure.
Are we going to walk down these steps, or are we going to have to do the whole thing in reverse?
Well, it's just a reminder that once you leave, you don't get to come back. That's why she's making sure. Hey, is there anything else?
Anything? Can you tell me what my dad left? I'm kidding.
Wow.
I'm kidding! I already know that answer.
Sasha. Are you able to send messages to those who have passed?
Passed in what way?
Passed from this world, who have died.
No. My powers are limited.
Do you know if any of your comrades or associates have this ability?
I have not made contact with them before. I do not know.
Thank you. I figured it was worth the ask. But that is all.
All right, children. Are you ready to go?
Yeah, Dad, let's go.
Do we want to talk to those other, what were their names? Arthur and Dragonbait? Before we leave?
We can talk them all the way out if we want to.
I mean, if they were here, they probably were in need of something.
Time is not in abundance in Chult, if you haven't noticed.
Yeah.
Make it quick.
Do I smell... I'm gonna step out to where they are, general area. Do I smell the brimstone again?
No.
Ah. Shut down my theories. Why don't you?
You instead smell ham again.
When I step out, do I also smell ham?
Edible.
please don't eat.
The scent of ham is coming like from, you know, over here.
Oh. Oh, she gonna eat him. Okay. Okay. Wow. I see how it is. You do you.
Herman,
I do not
tell,
judge
are you
lifestyles.
Two coming out of the thing?
I thought she was sending us somewhere.
No.
No, I have to do that.
I thought she was too.
Nope. She all gave right. you a thing to allow you to do that. Because as you all step out,
happy.
Am I really ever happy though?
No.
Okay.
I'm just a kid.
As you all step out, you notice that the lights and the scents and the chirps stop. And when you look behind you into the area, you see nothing but an empty, disheveled inner sanctum.
Cool. I'm gonna start running down the steps.
Wait. You do that.
I miss my bird, Becky. I'm
are you
go
going to
Becky
give me an acrobatics check real quick?
There you go.
Sure. That's going to be a flat 20.
Okay.
Oh, thank
just
God.
Making sure you're not going to trip on the literal shitload of vines and stuff that are still existing here.
No, I'm gliding over those. No, I'm okay. kidding.
Yeah, you're good. But yeah, you guys smelled ham coming out, and you see kind of Arthur kind of whispering to Dragonbait.
Hey, you guys need anything? Being kind of secrets tell no one, but I think we're all in the same boat here, and you know, if there's anything an adventurer could do for a fellow.
He looks over at Dragonbait and back to you with like a raised brow, like, do we have the same interests? Do you know of a man named Razin C?
Okay, player me thinks I have, because that sounds very familiar. No, okay.
You haven't.
I have not, okay. Well, I have not heard
you
that
could
name,
always
but...
try lying.
Yeah, but I don't want to lie to these people.
I was out of character, I'm not saying that, but yes.
Yeah, I know. Well, I don't, but... maybe if we cross paths again, we could talk more, but I'm afraid my friends and I should be on our way. But I figured that if you needed anything in passing, it would be nice to give you something. It's dangerous out here in the forest or the jungle.
We're aware. We have been traveling for some time.
Yeah, you can't remember how long.
Well, he did say sometime. If you do plan to go to that goblin city in the north, city being a loose term, I will tell you, be aware, there is, at least in the mountains, near Yelyark, the home of a dragon.
Oh, that's wonderful.
That is some quite useful information.
He kind of looks over at like it's her name was Tinder, wasn't it? And Dragonbait just like shakes his head.
So
I ain't swiping left on that.
Jesus.
God, I hate you so much.
So what is it? It's mountains near Yelyark. Right. And then what was the name?
Tinder.
I've actually never downloaded the app, so I don't know which way you swipe.
Wait. you know, let's table that, and if we come across you again, we'll talk more about it, but my...
I have some questions for you.
Sure, ask away.
What was this death curse you were talking about?
It's pretty self-explanatory, okay, really.
Real quick, before I answer, can I vibe check and see if they're, like, trying to, like, get information out of me for a certain reason, or if they're actually curious? Cool. How are we gonna do this? Come on. That looks like a good number. That's a 19.
As far as you can tell, he's genuinely curious.
Okay. I hate the as far as you can tell, but... Oh, well, it's basically if you die and you come back to life as a resurrection or some non-necromantic way, you start to deteriorate in a quicker manner than if you were to come back at any other place.
Is this just happening here?
From what we were informed, it's just in Chult.
DM note, it's everywhere.
It's everywhere? Oh.
The entirety of Faerun.
No, yeah, we came from somewhere else from Chult.
The entirety of Toril, the whole world.
Retcon. Yes, it is. It's happening everywhere. It's not just here. So consider yourselves lucky that you're not dead or that you haven't died.
Kind of looks over. I would not say that's lucky, but do you even know where this thing's at?
Not how to stop it? Not a clue, and I'm going to just start walking down the stairs.
What an oddly... I don't even know if the word is confident.
I believe the word you're looking for is stupid.
Yeah! Tell him, Johan!
I'm just gonna walk down. I'm not, like, running, but just to make it faster.
Yeah, as you descend, you know, all the stuff does not seem to, like, affect you descending. And they start descending the steps and just do-do-do-do-do.
I can't find that teleportation charm. Does it say that there's a certain amount of people that I can take with me?
It was under the symbol of Ubteo. Nope, just anyone within 30 feet of you that's willing.
Cool.
But it is a one-way trip.
Yep.
Come on, Herman. Let's go.
Oh, okay. Hi, Herman.
Sorry, I didn't realize you guys were moving.
He just warps.
Skateboard.
He said no,
down.
I get there right now.
Is there anything anyone would like to do before
I
continuing?
I
want to
pet Becky.
I would like to go pee.
I guess this would be a good short break time for everybody.
So we're
going to take a quick break. Please stand by.
Yep. Excited for Goblin Town.
Yeah, Goblin Town.
We're not gonna judge the goblins. We're gonna go in there as nice people.
And then we're gonna kill them because they're obviously gonna resist when we try to take their god.
Of course.
Oh my god. Thank everyone for being here watching on this night of all nights. We will be
welcome back, everybody. So, yes, we are here at the bottom steps of Orolunga. What do you do?
Is everyone ready to go?
Yeah, I mean, I'm gonna feed Becky some of my rations.
I also
bolted down there before everyone else, so she's been kind of chilling down there.
Yeah, can you make sure that she knows that we're gonna teleport mm-hmm. and is okay with it?
Yeah, yeah, okay. So I'm gonna stand in front of Becky. I'm gonna put my hands together. Now, Becky, listen to me, okay? We're gonna do a thing. We're gonna teleport. It's gonna be a little scary, but it's fine. I'm right here. And she's just gonna be talking to the axe beak. Like face to face, having a conversation, like a one-sided conversation.
And at that point, you're gonna start smelling ham again.
What the?
And brimstone.
Oh. Okay.
Is,
hey,
I'm gonna.
What? I'm yelling over
Raise the sum.
To what's their these guys over here. Why do you smell so bad?
Brimstone, where the fuck is it? Where the fuck is it?
They kind of look at each other like bad.
Dude, like it's not even consistent. It just pops up in and out. Like what's going on?
I'm getting meat and brimstone.
When you say this, you now, like, those kind of scents kind of start to dwindle, and now you start smelling roses.
What the?
All right.
So, let's just teleport. I don't care.
Okay. Flask, River, are you guys okay with teleportation?
I guess, love. Where are we going?
Don't worry about it. And then I just raise my hand up.
Secondary location.
And say, by the power of Saja, let's go to... Yeah, that's what I was going for. Glad you caught that. I have to find the name, because I'm bad with memory.
See, my character is smart. I'm not. Just kidding. Neither of us are smart. Street smarts!
By the power of Saja, let's go to Yo-Yark.
All right.
And then I just do a teleport.
Yeah, so you concentrate on the name Yo-Yark. A place you've never been?
Yes.
A place you don't even know what it looks like?
Yes.
Find out now.
Find out on the next episode of...
No, don't you worry. We still got time.
No, see you next week.
Sorry, guys.
Why isn't this button working?
Can we fight something so I stop looking at certain things on my phone real quick? You should never look at your phone during D&D, but it's an exception for today.
Johan, roll me a D20.
All right. Let's fight something, Johan.
That one. Let's go. What do we get? We got a 17.
Damn.
That terrifies me because I get okay rolls on natural D20s.
You end up there.
Oh, hold on. Let's go back to location. Where are we?
We're in an endless void of hexagons. All around us is just white space.
Oh my god, it's just hexagons.
You are not sure as to the exact location.
So we're in Provo,
where
Utah.
Where you are.
Yeah.
So you believe you're closer to Yo-Yark.
Well, this is a quite nice patch of jungle.
This is a nice hexagon.
Hey, Tal. Would you by any chance be
good
at finding a civilization?
Luca thought that November 3rd couldn't get any worse. So she decided to make it worse.
Luca!
Luca, you're so polite, but what are you giving? Are you doing a bad table or are you doing good tables?
No.
A bad table.
We've changed
Luca.
It.
We know what she's doing.
Oh, bad
table. Wow. Whoa, guys. Luca chose the bad table. Crazy how that happens.
$10 is always bad table.
Listen, we've had it before. People just give us $10 and want two good tables.
No longer is that the system.
Hmm, 29.
First off, okay, hold up. Before we get into this, and before we're wilding out, what does it feel like when we just get yeeted into this place, and where do we land?
Okay, so you feel yourselves being almost consumed by earth and foliage, and then kind of like the earth and foliage drop, and you end out into kind of a clearing, not really, of the jungle.
And then Johan asks me that, and basically right as I'm about to say, yes, I'm very well suited in nature, if you couldn't tell. And then whatever happens, I assume, is happening.
Another ice giant.
Yeah, that's not going to work for this specific situation. 41.
I can't tell which is worse, the bad table or my wild magic.
Okay. Who's this going to affect? A D4, is it? Who's number
it's
two?
Me.
Who's,
it's
oh,
me.
God. Oh, it is you. Oh, God.
Get... Yeah, it is me.
Yeah, hey, Johan.
Yeah.
For the next 3 days.
Okay.
Every time you attempt to speak, including to cast a spell, you have to make an intelligence save. Or you instead have to deliver a lengthy and discursive monologue on something.
Every time he does what?
He wants to speak or cast a spell, he has to make an intelligence save.
Remember that bit I made at the beginning of the stream before we started going live? And Cole, you asked me, what does Herman think right now? And I said, this is going to be the death of us all. I was correct.
Okay, Cole, real quick, give me some monologue tips before I have to speak in character ever again.
Well, you...
Strong, decisive voice, a clear... Oh, George. Oh, Lee, what is going on?
Just need to make a lot of metaphors and a lot of references and talk, even though you don't know where it's going. Sometimes.
Awesome. Sounds like,
oh, here. That's what I'm trying
like
to say.
What I do normally.
A strong, concise thesis statement.
Sometimes you'll start a sentence and you don't even know where it's going.
I can do that.
You have, if you fail the intelligence save, you roll a d10 and you have to go on a spiel about other topic instead.
What? I don't even get to choose the topic? Okay.
No, you don't get to choose the topic.
Have fun making extensive research.
You know, the funny
and
thing
if
is
you repeat the same roll, you have to continue.
Okay.
You know, the funny thing is that, one of these things is something I already thought of doing, so it's fine. I'm not going to say which one it was, but...
Before you say anything, let's rewind time a little before this bad table. What specifically did you ask Tel?
I asked him if he was good, if he would be good at finding a civilization.
Yeah, so...
Like a city.
We're in the middle of the jungle. I'm definitely going to roll to try to see where the best place is to survive right now, because I am somewhat concerned about the stuff we've already burnt, and we did not rest on those pillows like I would have hoped we did. So, would you like me to roll a survival check?
Sure.
How absolutely
18.
And you're trying to figure out what exactly?
Where the closest and best place is to survive the best right now. I'm basically
from where
looking
you are?
I'm basically looking for shelter, yeah.
Well, because you are unsure of exactly where you are in the jungle, although you might be able to make out the tips of mountains to the north and west of you, the next best option is up a tree.
Up a tree, huh? Well, looks like we're not in the best of places right now. I am going to kind of just kneel down and put the big meaty hand down to the ground. And I'm going to try to locate a bear. Using locate animals or plants.
Okay.
And here is where I make my first intelligence.
I learn the direction and distance to the closest creature or plant of that kind within 5 miles, if any present. So it says a specific kind of beast or plant. I'm assuming, is bear too specific, or?
No, bear is generic because there's a couple of kinds, but.
Okay.
Anything in the whole Ursus genus he's looking for.
Yeah, basically.
Okay, you put your hand down, say everything is connected, and you do not seem to feel the presence of a bear within 5 miles of you.
Yeah, Johan.
It's right there.
It looks like we're shit out of luck.
Oh, Johan.
Yep. I rolled a 5 on the D10 too.
All right, you get to talk about the correct method of preparing, storing, and administering a heretofore unknown and spectacularly deadly poison.
What? Cool, I get to talk about poison.
Oh.
How to prepare, store, and administer a heretofore unknown and spectacularly deadly.
I thought you rolled a 5.
Yeah, I rolled a 5.
Oh.
My bad. Wait. Oh, the various
I thought that was your intelligence save you're talking about.
No, I rolled a 7 on intelligence.
Oh, a 5. The various manias, phobias, or perversions of the nearest, most powerful monarch.
Who is the nearest, most powerful monarch?
That you know of?
Yeah, that I know of.
Woof. Merchant prince by the name of Wakanga, but I don't think you know his manias, phobias, or perversions.
What you think his manias, phobias, and perversions are?
Yeah, let's
make
go
up your own head. Make up your own headcanons.
Yeah, headcanon of Wakanga.
DM, are you writing all this down? Because this will be important later on.
Yes, here. Allow me to write here on my many a note-taking.
You know, Till, it's quite odd for you to put your head to the ground, but, you know, oddly enough, I feel that our employer, Wakanga, would probably do the same thing in the situation. You know, after the short while that we've known him, I feel like he might have developed, because of his, you know, what? How would you say, enjoyment of staying in the safety of his own home, that I fear he may have developed a phobia of trees. He might just.
All right, so this is already too much talking for Tell, so he's going to. Sing.
A phobia of trees?
He's going to sing out to the plants, and he's going to say, "Do you hear the people singing the song of angry men? It is the music of a people who will not be slaves again. When the beating of your heart echoes the beating of the drums." And he's going to reach out to the plants and try to have them silence Johan and wrap around his mouth.
Excuse me. Is Tell a bard?
I get he's
or are you just channeling mad Sir Heck vibes?
It's a Bruid.
I am just
a person.
Right, I'm a person of the people. Anyways, he speaks to the plants by singing to them.
and asks them to shut Johan up.
I mean, you could just ask me to do it. I like a cut, G.
So you just speak with plants?
I don't want... Well, yeah, did you not hear me speaking to them and motivating them?
We'll clip it later. Sure. Your singing gives them so much goddamn happiness. The vines around just kind of encompass Johan and just shook right over his mouth.
And I just slap him on the back. It's nothing personal, friend, but you seem to have come down with something.
Hell, I mean, I could have just smacked him if you wanted me to.
I didn't want to hurt him. And I just pick him up and throw him on my shoulder and start walking. Are we just picking a direction or...
Pretty much, because you are not 100% sure.
All right. Where you are. So if you see my ruler, we're walking this way. I don't know what way that is. If north is the top, we're walking southwest, we'll say.
Why wouldn't we walk towards the mountains?
I don't fucking know, Herman. Where are we going?
Well, you do know that these mountains, as Arthur told you, have the home of a dragon named Tinder.
Oh, yeah. The lonely dragon.
I was just thinking we get some higher grounds.
Herman, you lead the way. I'll carry him. And he just has Johan on his shoulder.
Up to y'all. But... I'm asking the group, I guess, in character now. Should we head further into the forest, or should we head towards the high ground, that is, the mountain range just beyond the horizon there?
All right. Out of game, is this a forest or a jungle? Because Tell's quite confused.
It's both.
In all technicalities, yes. It's a jungle.
Okay.
It's a fungal. Wait.
No. No.
No.
All right.
Stop it.
With I don't know. I already said it. Tell has Johan on his shoulder and is just starting to march southwest.
Okay. Is that where everyone plans to go?
Well, if that's going that way, then
Johan's going, I'm going to win. So let's go.
All right. You go southwest. You do not get lost. For your day's travel.
You better hope I don't.
Well, I'm telling remember, tales. You have two guides giving you, you know, the help.
Oh, yeah.
Just because you go in a direction does not mean that that is a complete linear good to go. You might get turned around because of plants or rubble or who knows what. But the rest of your day pretty much goes without incident.
Tony, does a 17 beat my talk save?
Are you planning to talk again?
Yeah, I was just going to say to Tell that I can walk by myself.
Yeah, you're good.
Okay. Yep. Tell, can you put me down? I might talk a lot, but I can walk on my own.
All right. He will put you down. Was that a day where we had a long rest then?
Yeah, you would have all gotten a long rest at the end.
Gosh.
Yeah, one day down.
I need my freaking wild shapes back.
Hmm.
All right.
Two more days left.
When the next day comes, it's kind of like drizzling today. It's not awful, but... Which direction do you choose to continue?
We're trying to find this goblin place, right?
Mm-hmm.
I thought... Oh, man. I don't know. Before I decide direction, I'm going to... I guess less about survival this time, but try to track any bit of direction that someone else or any goblins have gone at all.
Okay. Give me a... Survival check at disadvantage.
Oh no!
Not a good sound.
Unless you are asking anybody else to assist. Oh god. No.
Master of Rem for the raiding party.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you.
Come party with us in the death jungle.
What an unfortunate time for someone to drop on the call.
You've joined us at basically the wrongest of all times.
The worst of the times.
If you would like assistance, I will give you a straight roll for survival. But due to the rain...
Tell would not ask anyone for assistance, but if anyone is offering it, he wouldn't say no.
Are you informing the party of what you're doing?
Well, yeah, we're all just kind of standing here, so he just says, like, give me a second, I'll see if I can find anything.
What you looking for, love?
We're looking for the goblin camp.
What'd you roll? What'd you get?
Am I rolling?
Well, for Johan, because he wants to talk.
Oh, okay. Yeah, go ahead, Johan.
I was gonna... So I was attempting to ask River and Flask where they might know where Yo-Yark is, but I rolled an 8. So...
What's your... roll your D10.
Yeah, let's see what I get. I got a 7. What's a 7?
The best tourist destinations in the nearest village.
Cool. And I don't know the nearest village.
To you, it'd probably be Mbala.
To me, it would be Mbala.
Yep, the best things that you could find for tourists for the Mbala village.
So, guys, I've kind of I've recently gained an appreciation for the wildlife out here. And, you know, thinking back on it, Mbala would probably be a great place for tourists to come. Mostly because, you know, you get to see the ruins of a past civilization, and my god, the view is just amazing. And, you know, honestly, I bet that Madam Granny Pu’pu could honestly make a killing from selling that soup, quite literally, if I might add. Although I guess that could be either an upside or a downside, but I guess it would be only a matter of time before, after this death curse in the jungle is sterilized of anything dangerous, that it might become such, and I would love to be a part of that, if I may add. Because, you know, property, you know, getting
monologue to fill in this time while we're waiting for Night Dungeonistics to come back?
Dungeonistics Wi-Fi is really borking. So it might be a second. We are gonna cut to an intermission real quick, because this is... The cameras are so borked, it's really hard to fix on the fly. I apologize, but we'll be right back.
It'll be fine, everybody.
My internet drops again.
Back.
I apologize.
We're back. We made it back.
You survived.
Oh, sorry. Technical difficulties are quite annoying.
Tomb of Annihilation. More like Computer of Annihilation.
No, yeah. Exactly.
Trash.
I'm glad someone laughed at that, because it wasn't a good joke.
Anyway, I like bad jokes. I genuinely love bad jokes.
Exactly. So bad jokes are humor.
You were looking for goblin tracks.
I rolled a 12, unfortunately.
You rolled a 12. You do find some, but due to the impending rain, you're not sure which direction they are going.
Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to camp out for 2 nights straight and watch and listen and hang out.
Are you?
Yep.
Okay.
And we're going to make sure that Johan just sits there quiet and reads the journal, and that's it.
Okay.
Johan is going to attempt to speak again.
Johan, I said just read the journal.
He got a four.
Oh, no. What?
And you rolled another 7.
Oh, you have to continue your monologuing of Umbala's greatest tourist destinations.
So as I was saying before I was so rudely thrown a book at, I would very much love to get in on the soon-to-be tourist attraction of Mbala, because I'm sure that with the ruins, there is surely something inscribing their history upon it.
I go to bed, and I mute Johan as I fall asleep.
Okay, so...
Wait, you mute... Okay.
This will be good. All right. It's nighttime. Who would be taking the first watch of the evening?
I can.
Neat.
Yeah, if Johan's talking a bunch, I'm going to bed.
Give me a perception check.
All right.
How many goblins are there?
That's gonna be a 10.
Oh, okay.
I don't like the way you said that.
That's fine. Everything's fine. Let
not
me just
to repeat
flip
Luca,
my book
but I don't like
through.
How you said that.
Why are you guys just so paranoid? I only have a book in front of me. Oh,
maybe I'll just bore the goblins.
I've never trusted books.
So
I am Jared, 19.
As everyone else is sleeping, and you're just there, like, whittling away at, like, a stick, You're so enthralled with your stick, you don't hear something coming up from behind you.
This is a good point to say I sleep as a T-Rex at all times.
You can, but you also, in what way are you doing that? Because they're too high of a CR for you to wild shape.
It's just a joke, sorry.
Well, you should be sorry.
I am sorry.
You feel the tip of a spear touch your back.
I don't like that.
And what are your languages?
I speak common, deep speech, infernal, and undercommon.
Okay. You hear what sounds like wisps and booming, kind like a mixture, coming from behind you, and you're not sure what it is.
Okay, I'm gonna kind of stop right where I am when I feel the tip of the spear. Not moving my head, I'm gonna look around just with my eyes, and everyone's asleep, right?
Yes.
All right, then I'm going to just kind of open my hands so that whatever I'm holding drops.
Mm-hmm.
Gonna kind of put my hands up.
I put my hands up.
Mm-hmm.
Playing my song. And I'm going to slowly attempt to stand up. Making it clear that I'm not being hostile.
And then you hear like some more wisps and booming after you stand.
Is the booming loud? Is it in the distance? What am I?
You can tell it's like right behind you, but it's the way that it, like, you don't understand the language, so I can't. It's hard to. It sounds like whisper, like wisps of the wind and like.
So.
Booming.
There's booming happening. Are we getting a chance to see if it wakes us up?
You give me perception checks at disadvantage.
Okay. You got it. I've been rolling like shit already. Let's keep it going.
Oh, I don't.
It's not like a loud booming. It's not like a crack of thunder followed by boom.
Well,
that'd be a 10.
11 for me. Or, wait,
you are
sorry.
Still dead asleep.
15.
I got less than.
Oh, okay. Tell you start to wake up in a groggy like state. You can tell by the campfire that, you know, you see Nethrissa hands up, standing up, and you make out four creatures behind her with spears in hand.
Well, I am groggy, so instead of going balls to the wall, he's gonna stand up. I wouldn't do that if I were you.
What are your languages?
Common, Druidic, Elvish, Giant, and Undercommon.
Okay, yeah.
Hey, Undercommon.
As soon as you start to get up, you hear, like, one of them yelling in whists and booming at you.
Yeah,
And it starts to, like it points its spear at you.
Yeah, I'm just gonna walk, like, not a care in the world, put the tent or whatever to the side. I wouldn't do that if I were you. And,
you then hear it say, you must not understand what I said.
I definitely don't. How about we find a language we both speak?
I speak common.
Literally just did.
Well,
it starts to speak common.
Okay, yeah, I mean.
Well, you should have started with that in the first place. I didn't understand a word you said.
Shut it.
No.
Who are you people and why are you here?
We're here to save the land, and that's about it. And we're just people banded together to do that.
Well, a lot of the people that have been coming through here have done nothing but loot and kill.
What do these people look like?
Since Ethrissa hasn't turned, you notice that they are avian in appearance.
Okay, cool.
Oh! Do they resemble my girl Becky in any way?
They sure don't at all.
Okay. I was going to be really upset if they did. Cool.
They are Arakokra.
Oh, great.
Becky's parents are angry.
They'll make great jerky. I can assure you, we're not here to loot and kill. It's actually quite the opposite of what we want to do.
Yeah, we're actually trying to save people from dying.
Hmm. You have any evidence?
You know, that is a very good question. Unfortunately, our word is our only evidence, and the fact that I haven't turned into a giant ape and smacked the shit out of you is maybe second evidence. We're here to investigate the death curse.
I mean, okay, you know what? Maybe one of our previous party member wrote down something about it.
When you mention the death curse, the spear that's touching Nethrissa's back leans off.
Oh, okay.
You know of this curse?
Yes, we do.
Yeah.
Unfortunately.
And are you here to stop it?
That's the goal.
Mm-hmm.
Do you know where it is?
Everywhere.
No.
I meant the source.
Not yet.
That's what we're trying to figure out.
It's troubling.
Can I wake up our other compatriots so they're not startled?
If you wish.
Just give me a second. Herman, Johan, wake up. We have friends. No danger.
Oh. You just got a good table.
The dankest.
Yay!
Yay!
Let's see what today has in store, or this evening has in store for y'all.
Thank you, Juice.
Tell, I always feel if you have to say there is no danger, it still gives me quite a deal.
We're fine, Herman.
I can understand how in normal circumstances that would make sense, but we're talking about me here.
I got a 13. I got a 13 for speed roll.
You're good.
I'm good. Who are we being? Who would visit us in the night if we're not being robbed?
Bird friends.
Johan, just come out here, stand, shut up.
Okay. I do so.
I'll wait for you to solve the good table before we get too much further.
All right. Okay. Who's that gonna affect?
No, that's not.
It's gonna affect Johan.
Yeah. Oh, great.
Johan, as you're getting up and you're moving through, you kind of get a little bit of this puddle splashed onto you. For the next day, you have advantage on history checks and a +1 to all skill checks.
Damn!
Yay! I am a plus one pirate, if you will. Okay. Hey, remember how I was talking about Mbala earlier? I feel like that Taurus thing would really help right now.
All right, oh, Johan. No. Just hold.
Uh-oh. Did that mess everything up?
No, I think we're good.
My camera had a thingy.
I think we're good.
Okay.
The name's Teleftaos, by the way, and you are?
Unimportant.
Fair.
You seem to be trying to help the land, and we appreciate it. So, we'll give you this if you promise to keep to your word. And he holds out a small, what looks like a vial, but carved from bone.
I'll reach out and grab it, see what it is.
Again, it's a vial. It looks to be made out of bone. You can see on the side there's actually an inscription in it, but you are not sure what it says.
Oh yeah, this greatly matches my aesthetic. But what is it?
A vial of poison.
Okay. We're here to save people, not poison them. Might I ask why?
Well, near our home here, there is a dragon. Mm. If you were to cross paths, this could help you fight it.
We have heard about the dragon. Well, currently we're in search for some goblin village. Do you know of it?
Yeah, it's due a few days east of here.
Of course it is. What are your feelings towards the people that inhabit it?
The queens are a very vain individual, as goblins can be here.
I'm not one to judge.
But she can be persuaded if given the right I don't want to phrase it. Indulge her in her vanity.
Any tips?
We don't meet with them because they're weird. So but we kind of have an understanding.
Is there anything we can do to help you?
I mean, we would love for the dragon to be gone, but we can't expect you to go fight a dragon.
Well, maybe when I'm a bigger boy. I got some working out to do.
He like looks you up like you're like a foot and a half taller than him. He's like, right.
Well, it was great meeting you, but I guess we're heading west, east now.
West, east, yes.
Johan, are you able to talk without talking too much?
Well, let's see.
Yeah, are you, Johan?
No. See, what do I roll on the D10? Where is my D10? It's right there. What's a four? What does a four get me?
The life cycle of the cherub.
Cherub. What's a cherub?
Oh, gosh.
I'm kind of, I think I know what it is,
isn't
but I want to
make sure.
Cherub,
like those little cute little angel things?
Yep, they sure are. Think of Cupid. But
the things that, like, let us into the temple? Or the, up the stairs? Is that what it is?
No, that's a chwinga. A cherub is something else.
Cool. Well, funny that you ask that, Phil, because, you know, I just had on my mind.
Apologies, one second.
There was a creature that I was.
Can I smack him, Tel?
He puts his hand over your mouth, which probably covers half of your face, and just. Herman. Herman. Do you have.
Can I knock him out non-lethally?
No, please, Nathrissa.
I'll just knock him out. I won't do any damage. I'll just
Herman, knock him out. Is there anything you would like to talk to our new friends about?
It is far too late for me to have a valid comment at the time. As long as they're not here to kill us, I think I'm going back to bed.
I create a minor illusion to, like, make the image of a goblin sprinting past there behind the tents to try to distract the bird, the Aarakocras. That does not require a verbal component, and it's a 5-foot cube. So
you're just gonna make goblins appear?
Like, I'm gonna, like, make the image of a goblin sprinting behind the tents appear behind us. Like, as far away as I can, so that they don't think that it's in our camp. So, like, a full 30 feet away, like, a goblin is, like, running between trees.
I mean, they might, if they see it, they'll just, appears your camp might be infested with these goblins.
I'm not quite sure that's the case. Our friend here is cursed. Should hopefully be gone in a day or two. But I don't wish to waste any more of your time. I thank you for this meeting.
Mm-hmm. And they just, you know, kind of bend down and fly off into the trees.
Johan, go to bed. Sleep this off.
Literally, please.
Go the fuck to sleep.
I will knock your ass out if you don't go right now. I will turn this car around.
Speaking role. I got a 12. Does a 12
You're good.
You're cool. Good. I think it's funny that you think you could tell me what to do, Nethrissa. And I'm just gonna walk
toss
into
you.
The tent.
I will toss you. I'll walk over to him right
and
now.
I'm in the tent and going to sleep.
I'll rip that thing open with my hands.
Well, back to bed. Can we make it through to get Johan uncursed?
The rest of the night is uneventful. So that was day two of your 3-day curse.
Yeah.
Disrespect from Johan.
All right, we might as well travel east now and get over with.
Well, you have the option. Do you continue to go northeast or southeast?
I'm heading to the goblin camp, right, everybody?
Mm-hmm. Sounds good to me.
Yep.
No, I'm nodding my head.
It's just for the semantics of how the hexagonal map works.
You want me to tell you northeast or southeast?
Pretty much.
Does anyone want to decide that's not me?
Southeast.
I point to Nethrissa.
All right, southeast.
This black dot is what represents that area. Southeast. Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
Let me see something real quick.
Never a good thing to hear from a DM.
I'm not.
That's life in general. Okay, you are good. So, fun little tidbit. The rest of, again, your rest of your day, as I mark it down here for future reference, is uneventful until you go to get ready to set up camp for the evening. And you find something.
Oh,
something you've been looking for.
Oh, yes.
A mysterious statue.
A statue?
Standing next to some rocks and ferns is an 8-foot tall statue, humanoid in shape with bronze fists, iron joints, and an adamantine breastplate with an iron helm with slits for eyes. The rest of the statue is made of sculpted wood, reinforced with bands and rivets of adamantine. Scattered around its feet are offerings of food, feathers, colored stones, and skulls.
Well, I'm pretty sure that this is very close to what a god might be worshipped as.
GM.
This might be our tom-tom.
I know they're technically from Eberron, so would Herman be aware of Warforged or not?
You can give me a history check because there is an out for Warforged in the Forgotten Realms.
Well, dang, that's a natural 20. Not that it really matters, but it's a 20.
You have heard that the Gnome Tinkers of Lontan, which, if you actually look at the map, is in the northwest corner, are known to have been creating more advanced creations, some of which have sentience, like Warforged.
With that knowledge, then, could I establish whether this is just an automaton or something that might have intelligence of its own?
You can give me an investigation check.
Well, let's hope I'm just as lucky as I was before.
Can I assist with the investigation? Because I'm also trying to figure out if this is the automaton.
Sure.
Just going to give advantage because I don't have a good
Either way, I have a 5 or a 7.
Oofy boofies. As far as you can tell, this is probably, it's not active at all. There is no semblance of sentience or activation or anything coming from it. There are no sounds, movements, or otherwise.
It seems we have found our automaton. And as far as I could tell, it is exactly as described. There is no soul within this thing.
So I can take its armor, is what you're saying.
I don't think that's what should happen.
Would not recommend it.
But I guess now all that's left is to find the amulet that controls it, which reasonably, I guess, would probably be in, I want to say the name of a different city, but I know that's not it. I suppose that the amulet may be in Yonor if we don't have it already.
What do y'all want to do?
I want to go up to it and say, I like a cut G. I'm kidding. Can I want to look at the skulls and stuff that's at the base of it. Does it seem to be, basically, what am I looking at? I'm seeing there's food, feathers, colored stones, and skulls. Are there any, is there any like signs of trauma to the skulls? What's the food like? Are the colored stones painted natural color? What's up?
Any of these skulls are anywhere from animals to humanoid. And there are some larger bestial skulls. All of these seem to have some kind of cracks or broken or missing pieces to them.
Okay.
Some of the smaller ones, like the, you might find like a bird skull doesn't have that, but anything like a humanoid size or larger does.
Is there a specific point that they all have in common with a crack or something, or is it all just kind of random?
You can give me a medicine check.
Let's go. That's going to be a 17.
They all seem to have what you would assume is blunt force trauma to the skull, primarily around the frontal and temporal areas.
All right, I'm going to look at these kind of. Ow. Sucks for them. All right, and then what kind of food?
Any of the food is anywhere from rotted meats to rotted fruits because they have been here spoiling in the rain. There are some scraps and it looks like maybe birds or small animals have come to eat it and then be like, wow, this is gross, and went away.
Okay. Can I tell about how long it's been rotten there?
Anywhere from, some are just there from like, you would assume maybe a day or two because of the sheer amount of moisture, to a week.
Okay. So relatively recent.
Mm-hmm.
And then the colored stones, are they painted or are they naturally colored?
Some of them are naturally colored. Others are anywhere from like a red paint or an off
blood
like an off purple. Even some are like a weird yellowy orange color.
Okay. All right. Well, I'm just going to kind of take some time to look over all of this. I don't have any leads currently, so I'm just going to let someone else take it.
DM, what does a 5 get me?
A 5 gets you a failure.
No, for the D10. I rolled an 8.
Oh boy. A 5. The various manias, phobias, or perversions of Wakanga Otama.
Hasn't it been 3 days though?
It's about to be 3 days.
It's about to be. Hopefully this is the last one.
Tonight's the last night of his shenanigans.
All right, go ahead, Johan. Go ahead.
So, if you might recall, a couple of days ago, I started talking about how Wakanga might have a fear of trees, but, you know, if you were to come out here and see this and not think that it was the automaton, you know, this is a pretty scary looking tree, and, you know, I'm pretty sure if I saw this, it would give me a fear as well. However, I don't think I would stay in my house as much as he does. And yet I still haven't seen him put his face in the dirt like you did tell. But maybe it's not, maybe it's not because... Maybe it's not because he's afraid of trees, but maybe it's because he's afraid of bones. But then he'd be living in fear his entire life, wouldn't he?
What if he was afraid of dirt?
You know, that could be true. What if he was afraid of dirt?
When she says this, she like looks so amused. Like, she knows she's messing with him. She knows she's just messing with him.
He's so clean all the time.
Yeah.
That is very, he could have a phobia.
How many times do you think he cleans the whole, his whole, like, place?
I think you're onto something.
Herman looks over at Nithrissa and sees her malicious smile and will thump her on the back as a not cut it out kind of thing.
I will turn this car around.
That might have happened with Wakanga. What if he got hit in the face by dirt?
Oh, you know, you're right.
A sandstorm and a giant chunk of dirt comes up and hits him on the face.
Oh my god. And then, and sand's just the worst. It gets
While he's fiddling with this monologue nonsense.
Yes.
Where could I see people coming and going from this location?
Give me that survival.
Wasn't a sentence, but okay. You know what I meant. Like, can I see tracks of people who have come or where they would have gone after
visiting this survival
thing?
Where do they come from? Where do they go?
Oh,
where
no.
Did they come from?
What'd you get?
From God knows where, because I got a freaking 2.
Ooh.
Oh, I'll be
so
right.
You
that
see
would
tracks.
Be a 1 plus a 1.
Ooh. Yeah, you see tracks. You're not even sure whose tracks. They're probably your tracks, but...
Are you sure this isn't, like, a perception roll?
I mean, you can see the tracks. It's you're trying to understand where they're going. Rip.
Suppose it would be rational to have a fear of dirt if he was wandering out in the jungle and saw a large footprint like that giant's.
Good stuff.
So I guess Herman's just looking around in circles.
You know,
he's used to the city life. He's not used to
You're following
to being
those
the
tracks
jungle.
Real good. You're following your own tracks real good in a circle.
Also, that could have also been a factor. What if, you know, maybe instead of seeing large tracks, he just saw his own and thought there was a ghost following him? Not that a ghost would leave tracks. Oh my
God.
At
this point, you are going to settle in for your evening.
Thank God.
good job. Good job, Johan.
Are you guys sticking close to Vorn, or do you guys want to kind of stay a little far away?
I think that I would want to stay close to the package that we're supposed to deliver.
Okie doke.
As long as no one objects.
Sounds good.
The rest of your evening? Pretty good. Pretty good.
Oh, thank God.
No events. And Johan, you wake up the next day, you feel like you don't have to talk nearly as much as you have been.
My jaw hurts, guys. What was I talking about so much that I just couldn't stop? Like, my jaw is genuinely sore. Hello? I'm just gonna investigate because nobody's saying anything. I'm gonna see if they're dead in their beds.
Stretching my legs. I'm still waking up. What did you say?
What did I feel the need was so important that I had to talk until my jaw hurt?
The jungle is a weird place. I don't know.
Anyways, should we go north or go northeast or southeast of the statue to look through the town?
Southeast, I guess. Nethrissa wanted southeast, right. So.
Nethrissa did want to continue southeast. So does southeast sound good for travel from the automaton?
Sure.
Yes, let's go.
You travel southeast. Hey. Trying to grab that little bastard.
Oh.
That's not gonna work. Okay. You travel, southeast, and your day is uneventful. No rain today, just good old fashioned humid.
Oh, God, this is terrible. I think our luck's run out with the southeast. Let's start heading further north tomorrow.
Are we?
GM.
Yeah, yes.
Would we start to recognize the area that we're in yet?
Not quite yet.
Well, gosh darn it, we're basically close enough.
Close, but no cigars.
Why are we disappointed that we haven't run into any trouble, Johan?
It's not that I'm disappointed that we haven't run into any trouble. I'm just disappointed that we haven't found the goblin town that most likely has our amulet.
Well, northeast it is then. Carry on.
We're almost there.
All right.
I can feel it in my bones.
Also uneventful. And that's it. It's uneventful.
God.
Today it's a real scorcher out there, everybody. It's
then
super
I'm just
hot.
Gonna say out of character, we're just gonna keep going northeast until we hit something fun.
Yay. All right.
Okay.
Becky. Let's follow Becky.
Yeah.
Okay.
As usual. No, actually, I am not going to wild shape if we see the city because we're gonna try to approach it non-threatening. So. I am staying my normal self that's more threatening than a furry animal. Cool. But it works.
Maybe we put you at the back of the line when we find the town.
That sounds good.
Yeah, maybe the tall people should be in the back. Aren't they, like, short?
Your next day, however. I should say your next evening. As it starts to get towards the night times, You arrive. Well, not quite arrive. As you start to get near, you are stopped by goblins.
Of course.
Their short bows are drawn and aimed at you. And does anybody speak goblin?
Nope.
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 This is great.
You know what I do have, though?
Comprehend languages?
Comprehend languages.
Yeah, I do.
I mean, I have a boomerang. Does that speak goblin?
Speaks bonk.
Speaks enough goblin that they'll know when
I'm using my charm of knowledge, which looks more like a creepy ass spider.
Mm-hmm.
And casting comprehend languages.
You do that. Your hand starts to glow for everybody, but only you can still see the symbol. And you notice that they kind of reel back a little bit, unsure of what you're doing.
I should probably look up what comprehend languages even does. Hold on a second.
You speak goblin, but
it allows you to like understand any spoken language, and if you touch words, you can understand a language you do not know by reading.
Lovely.
As long as it's spoken.
But I won't be able to talk to them, so we'll see how this goes.
So they
said anything.
Yes. So after you cast it, you can start understanding their broken speech of, "Who are you? Why are you here?"
Hail and well met. We are here to meet your glorious and beautiful queen. We are in need of information. Any of you speak common?
They look at each other. You speak weird. And like they actually start speaking in common now.
Well, I appreciate you for speaking your non-native tongues.
This man weird. Yeah, I know. He's super weird. He called Queen beautiful. I know. He's so weird. They're just like talking back and forth.
How would one find...
Oh, these guys are amazing.
How would one gain... I'm blanking on the word for it. Hold on. I got it.
Admittance.
Well, yeah, access? But there's a word I'm thinking of. Whatever. How would
audience?
One, there's the one. How would one gain audience to see your beautiful queen?
You want to see Queen Grabstab?
Sure.
Grabstab.
Why humans so weird? I don't know. Humans weird.
I'm sorry. He is
I
quite
do have
one.
To correct. I am a high elf, so I would appreciate it if you
pointy
do not
ear human sounds so
me.
Weird. I know he's
pointy
so weird. So a green human, tall human, and whatever that human
I'll fuck
look.
You up. I don't understand what he's saying.
Oh, no, they're speaking common.
This is
oh,
common.
They are?
We're
oh.
talking mad shit.
I'm like...
Come along, friend.
Don't you dare call me
perception.
A human, first of all. I'll rock your shit.
No, he's gonna turn back around to his party and say, come along, everyone. These strange hobbits here are in... need of a little bit of assistance.
What is hobbit? I don't know. Humans speak weird. Everybody give me a perception check.
Okay.
Forgive our friend. He doesn't
if only I could
much.
Use the perception 21. Check I rolled when I tried to find a way out of the... Ah, damn it.
15.
It's all coming together. I got a nat 1 with a plus 5, so 6.
That would be a 9.
Okay. Tell and Neth. You notice, looking in the trees, there are a lot of more goblins.
Oh, cool.
Aimed with their short bows at you.
Yeah, I'm going to walk up behind them talking and just put a hand on one of their shoulders. And I don't mean it threatening, but it's totally threatening.
Wait, you're walking behind the goblin that's in front of you?
Like side by side, not to scare them. And
he's
I'm just
very
gonna...
much going to step back and aim the bow at your kneecap. and tell you, no step close.
That's fine. And I'll just say, we mean no harm. We all may seem weird to each other, but we're all just a little different. I'm sure people think you're weird all the time, but we're not here to make those judgments against you.
Who say we weird? You the weird one.
Anyways.
You want to see Queen Grabstab, you need this, and he pulls out rope.
Thanks.
Quick question, GM.
No, I have rope.
How many of these people, or how many of these goblins are in front of us right now?
You see two in front of you.
Only two?
Yes, that's because your shitty, shitty perception, you don't see the ones in the trees.
Well, I rolled a 22
how
before.
Many do I
like, Tell gives you guys definite signals that, like, in the trees.
There's wow. From what you can see just from the distance of, like, your dark vision and campfire light, there's probably a good dozen plus in the trees nearby.
If I were to get this info from Tell, would I be able to notice them?
You can notice the ones nearby. There's a lot.
I'm going to get real close to Tell, where I imagine an ear might be. And I'm going to whisper in such general location. Do we try our best to keep them on our side? Or do we do our best to scare the living daylights out of them?
What languages have... You said you're an elf earlier, so you speak Elvish, right?
Mm-hmm.
So you hear a voice you've never heard before say, let's keep them on our side, friend. In Elvish.
In Elvish, I was saying.
Yeah.
Herman, eyebrows raise slightly higher and then settle back in and say, please, would you lead the way?
Yeah, and I'll just keep talking with them and just, they gave me a rope and I'm just not doing anything else but just following what they say.
Oh, they didn't just give you rope. They want to tie your hands together.
Oh, I ain't scared of that. I'll allow it. They think rope can... I am considered a large creature when it comes to lifting, pulling, all of that. You can tie mm-hmm. my hands. That's fine.
They just think you're weird humans.
Johan is going to pull out his rope and like start to tie it around his hands, and then he's going to do a quick like spin around and cast minor illusion to make it look like there's a rope around his hands that are tied together.
What is that weird human doing? I don't know. Humans are weird.
As I mentioned, we're just complying with what you want.
How he tie hands with his own hands?
He's a very skilled individual. Sword fighting, ship sailing, all of that. You tie a lot of knots when you sail a ship.
They're gonna... They failed their end check to see if it was fake. So they're slapped.
Oh yeah, they did.
But they're gonna pretty much put you in like a tie-up line. So...
Like a chain kind gang? Of, like,
pretty much. Rope gang. And they lead you to Yell Yark.
How nice of them.
And you notice this place is, there are two bonfires going. Well, quote unquote bonfires, they're just fires. One off to the north and one pretty much right in front of you where you end up. And I have to pull your tokens.
I wonder what this big black box on the map is.
What? A joke you'll find out later because it's hilarious.
Cool.
I couldn't quite give it to you guys right out the gate because it's too good.
All right. Hey.
Not scared at all.
Could I have attempted to tie my own hands up, but I want to do like a slip knot, but like secret slip knot. Probably or were they not. Gonna? No, okay. That's fair.
So yeah, these two goblins here. This.
Out of game. Remember when we killed a bunch of these same looking goblins?
And then we made a meat ladder? Okay,
so I would like to point out, when you come in here, you notice there are a shit ton of goblins in this village that you can see. And a lot more that you can't see in the forest that you can probably hear. But as you're walking through here, they tell you, you know, to step over this spot and move to the right at this spot.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we're not.
Can I attempt to keep track of these locations as we're going through?
Give me an intelligence check.
Intelligence, because the barbarian's great at that.
So good.
GM, what's she doing?
That's gonna be a 16.
Okay. Woo. Jot that down for later.
All right. All right, I'm gonna just slap it in the chat.
And as you come here, you notice that there are a couple of mounds. The center village portion has a few huts. One of them is slightly grand, comparably, with two goblins out front. And I think that's where we're going to end the session this evening.
Woo!
Dun, dun, dun.
Thank you, everybody, for being here.
Survived.
Yay.
They survived another for day. Now.
For now.
We have episode 8. Or
I
session
said
8.
Gun episode, and I was like, this I'm sorry,
old,
what?
This is
the gun episode.
Eight.
No, this was session 8, Visions and Secrets.
This was the Glock episode.
Thank you everybody for being here, supporting, giving them the delicious bad table of curse talking. if you guys all want to go around your overlay order, to give a fond farewell for the evening.